sorry. I'm sorry.
Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him there's no other. Jesus is the way. Jesus is the answer for the world today. Above him there's no other. Jesus is the way. Above him there's no other.
One more time.
Above there's no other. Jesus is the way.
Tell somebody around you, say,
Jesus is the way.
Oh,
Jesus is the way.
We gotta know that Jesus is.
Jesus is the way.
Rest in the truth that Jesus is.
Well, family, good morning, good morning, good morning, and praise the Lord, praise the Lord. I am so thankful and grateful to be sitting right here on this Sunday morning. This is May the 22nd. This is Sunday. Praise the Lord. I pray that your morning is off to a great start on this Sunday morning. If you are joining us for the first time, we welcome you to School of Wisdom here at the Bible Way House of Prayer. If you would like to learn more about who we are, feel free to visit us at www.thebiblewayhouseofprayer.org. Once again, www.thebiblewayhouseofprayer.org. There you will find out who we are, what we believe, and how to get connected. I'm so grateful and thankful to my natural and spiritual parents for giving me this opportunity on this morning to share what God has laid on my heart. I am Minister Christopher Jermaine Bell, the servant teacher on this morning, and I am so grateful and thankful to be able to share in the word with you on this morning. If you are joining us for the first time, again, welcome, 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 welcome. If you can see me, you have one reason to be grateful. If you can hear me, you have two reasons to be grateful. If you are able to maneuver through this heat and your feeling is all still intact and you still have your sanity, you have three reasons on this morning to be thankful and grateful and know that God is good and he really does love you on this morning. All right, to God's word, this morning's text is entitled Spiritual Weapons, Spiritual Weapons, and the text is taken from 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verses 1 through 10, and verses 17 through 18. I'm going to be reading from the the ERV version, as you will see on your screen. So here we are. The word says, I, Paul, am begging. In the text, it says, I, Paul's entreaty to the church of Corinthians. I, Paul, am begging you with the gentleness and the kindness of Christ. Some say that I am bold when I am writing you from a distance, but not that I am there with you, but not when I'm there with you. They think our motives for what we do are like those of the world. I plan to be very bold against those people when I come. I hope I will not need to use the same boldness with you. We live in this world, but we don't fight our battles in the same way the world does. Verse 4, the weapons we use are not human weapons. Our weapons have power from God and can destroy the enemy's strong places. We destroy people's arguments, and we tear down every proud idea that raises itself against the knowledge of God. We also capture every thought and make it give up and obey. Wow. We are able to capture every thought from using the weapons that God, from the weapons that we are equipped with. Verse 6, we are ready to punish anyone there who does not obey. But first, we want you to be fully obedient. You must look at the facts before you. If you feel sure you belong to Christ, you must remember that we belong to Christ the same as you do. It may seem as though we boast too much about the authority the Lord God gave us, but he gave us his authority to strengthen us, not to hurt you. I will not be ashamed of whatever boasting we do. I don't want you to think that I am trying to scare you with this letter. Some people say Paul's letters are powerful and sound important, but when he is with us, he is weak and the worst speaker you have ever heard. Verse 11. So I'm going to skip down to verse 17. I'm sorry. So that was verses 1 through 10. I'm now read verse 17 and 18. Whoever boasts should boast only about the Lord. What people say about themselves mean nothing. What counts is whether the Lord says they have done well. Once again, this text is entitled Spiritual Weapons, and I have given it a subtitle, which is Take the Lord Along With You Everywhere You Go. Take the Lord along with you everywhere you go. Family, on this morning, this text is quite interesting as we see and hear Paul is addressing once again the church, the Corinthians, the people in Corinth. And it's interesting. There is a situation at hand. The situation is this. Paul, though he's been writing and sharing the message of God, of Christ through letters, the concern from the people that they're struggling with is this. Paul, it seems as if you are a coward, some would say, when you are in person, Paul, you seem to be as if you are a coward and scared. You're not a lion, Paul. when you are speaking in person. But Paul, it seems as if you come across completely different when you are writing these letters. And so they're really wanting to know, Paul, who are you, and can we trust you to basically say what you mean? Because it seems as if what you're saying is not what's in your heart. And so the issue is not Paul. The issue is actually in their hearts, because the Bible tells us here that Paul tells the people that I am simply doing what Christ does. Christ often speaks with humility through scripture, and Paul is on the same thing. Again, they're wanting Paul to be a lion all the time, and oftentimes that's not the position we have to take as Christians, but simply speaking, you know, just with calmness sometimes is the best approach. Now there is a time that, you know, when we have to speak with authority and devour the enemy and his tactics, because granted, if he comes at us with aggression, we have to, the Holy Spirit will guide us through how we should speak, how we should respond, react to the weapons of the enemy. Again, Paul is urging them, hey, pay close attention to what I've been saying through these letters, because what I've been saying through these letters is word and life for you, for your longevity. If you hear it, if you, I'm just reminding you what's already in you. You have, that's all Paul is doing. He is reminding them what's already in them. So that's Paul's stance again, he's speaking oftentimes with humility. Paul also goes on, as we see in verses 3 and 4, Paul is reminding the church that we have weapons that we have to oftentimes ignite. What are these weapons? Now, Paul also says that we don't use the same weapons, that man created. Our weapons are not weapons that man created, but they are weapons that God himself created. And the only way to access these weapons is through the word. So, Chris, what are these weapons that Paul mentions? Well, Paul, these weapons are, the Bible says again, the weapons we use as Christians include prayer, the Bible, faith in Christ, and the power of the Holy Spirit that lives in us. These weapons are weapons that you can't create in your natural. Man did not create these weapons. These are weapons that were already created, designed specifically for the Christians, so that anytime we go to war or we're having to defend ourselves against the enemy, we have weapons, spiritual weapons to pull and pull from and to dismantle the enemy. Paul also goes on to say that if we are evangelists on this journey, Paul mentions that there are two important weapons that are highlighted in this text, verses 5 and 6, that one is polemics, as you will see on the screen. Two weapons that we can use. One is through form of polemics. Well, Chris, what is polemics? Well, Polemics is simply exposing false teachers. Whenever we cross people on this journey that are not out, thank you, Holy Spirit, they haven't accepted, they haven't connected with Christ yet. So what they may be speaking isn't Christ at all. That's when if you are an evangelist, polemics is one of the tools that you should use to dismantle false teachers. Another form tool that Paul mentions in this text that we can use is apologetics. Apologetics is efforts to clear someone of something that's not true. Here we are. Oftentimes you hear people, they say things about our Christ that we serve that's not true. Well, through the form, through the tool of apologetics, we're able to respond, clear the name of Christ, so that it's covered in love. We're able to dismantle and clear anything that's not accurately assessed to Jesus Christ through polemics or apologetics. Chriso, what are you saying? What are you saying? I believe on this journey, we have to have our spiritual weapons, and not just that, but Paul, I believe, is basically encouraging the church and us today that we must take the Lord along with us everywhere we go. We must take the Lord along with us everywhere we go. Quickly, I'm just reminded of one scripture in Joshua. Just taking a few steps back in Joshua, I don't think I shared it, but it tells us, I think it's Joshua, it may be on there, possibly, Joshua, how we must be brave, be courageous. We must be strong and courageous and not of fear. We can't be afraid to use our weapons when the enemy rises up against us. We cannot be afraid to respond spiritually to the enemy on this journey. Crystal, what are you saying on this morning? How does it look for us to walk every day, to take Jesus everywhere with us? What does that look like in the natural? Well, as you will see on the screen, a couple of ways for us to make sure that we're taking him everywhere we go, and what it does with us once we take him everywhere is on the screen. It says it reminds us to stay focused. Bullet points. It reminds us to stay focused. Number two, it keeps us alert. It keeps us alert. Number three, as we are taking God along with us, he oftentimes speaks through us. He will give us the exact words to say to dismantle our enemy, those that are against us. He will speak. He will rise up. That's why it's so important for us to accept Christ, because once we accept Christ, Christ starts living on the inside of us. And when he's living on the inside of us, he will give us the words to say to exactly convey the message to our enemy that he's wanting us to convey. Quick story about myself. I've been invited recently to share in places that don't necessarily believe what I believe. I'll even say they don't even believe God is the creator of the world. So here I am, I'm getting invitations to go in different environments that don't believe and embrace the same Jesus Christ, Lord, our Savior, Alpha. And so I'm having to question myself, well, God, why would you want me to go to this place? Well, when they don't believe, now these are churches, when they don't believe or subscribe to the same anointing, the same God that I believe in. Well, it's simple. God said, hey, I'm just sending you. So while they may see you, what they're not seeing is the weapon that's in you to dismantle or change the environment that they are currently in. I'm just sending you. They've called for you. Go and use the, because once you get in there, you're going to change the environment, because why? They sit, you go. Now, you must be careful. I didn't say you go and join. You can't go and join, because if you're not changing them, they are two things. Either you're changing them or they are changing you. Now, we don't want them to change us, because we know who we serve. We are the ones that are correct. We are walking with Christ. So it's our job on this journey to do what Paul is saying, ignite, use our spiritual weapons, and during the right time, God will allow us to convey and share his message. So whenever I go to these places and share music, whether I'm speaking verbally or I'm speaking through music, I'm only going to change the environment through my spiritual weapons. Also, taking God along with us, He guides us. Scripture tells us, which is not there, he's a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my pathway. He walks with us. He guides us. Paul has to also remind them, which is the last point, if we take God along with us, he warns us against sin. So Paul has to remind them, hey, don't get mad at me. I'm just sharing the word of the Lord. Don't get mad at me. On this journey, if we are if we are allowing the Holy Spirit to actively do what he needs to do in our lives, there are going to be places and things that he will not allow us to engage in. If we are actively allowing him to work in and through us, one of my favorite scriptures is, give us this day, God, our daily bread. If God is constantly giving us our daily bread and we are receiving it, because he's going to do his part. It's our part to make sure that we are opening our manual, our word, so that we can feast on what he's wanting us to do. If we are, it's going to be, again, certain things, certain places that he will not be okay with. That discomfort that you have at times, maybe I shouldn't do that. That's the Holy Spirit. You know, next week, this lesson is talking about Paul, how Paul had an issue and in his side. And, you know, we don't know exactly what that issue was, but, you know, Paul's prayer was, God, remove it. No. God's not going to remove our issues, but he will allow us to successfully overcome and navigate through this world that's full of sin. But we don't have to accept or engage in sinful things. But God will give us, he will guide us against those things. Yes, he will. Family, I pray. No, wait. The last verse is here. Verses 17. Paul, now, I believe for the mature believers, it's very important for us to not boast and brag. Verses 17 and 18. Paul wants the church to not boast and brag because this is not our own doing, but this is strictly from the Lord. This is how God actively works in us. And because he is actively working in us, we cannot get the credit. Paul mentions about how if you're in the, I am in the world of construction. If I take a hammer and build a home, does the hammer get the credit, or does the person that built the home, or do I get the credit? So granted, since we are tools, God himself, he's using us. We are simply tools, just like a hammer. We're just like a hammer that builds a home. We're simply vessels, tools that God uses to deliver, to change. Amen. So it's not our job. Don't boast. Don't boast, but give God the credit. He deserves all of the credit. Family, I pray that I've said something on this morning to encourage you on your journey. Remember, you have spiritual weapons. You have, use your spiritual weapons. Later on, praise and worship is a spiritual weapon. Praise and worship is a, so later on in service, get your praise on and ignite your spiritual weapons on the inside of you. Family, I pray you've been blessed on this morning. We would love to see you later in service. If not this week, please remember that we have paid off our church, and we are so excited about that. Yes, the Bible Warehouse of Prayer has been paid off in full, and we want to thank everybody that has been a part of the process, whether you sold a candy bar, a donut, or whatever it is, or just gave down through the years, 50 cents or thousands and thousands of dollars. Equally, we want you to come by on July 24th and celebrate with us in our celebration service. Again, we are so thankful to all of you that have been a part of this journey. You used your spiritual weapons to get through the process, and we believe that you will continue to take the Lord along with you on this journey. Family, I love you. Stay safe, stay prayed up, stay watchful, stay strong, and know that Jesus is Lord. Stay on this journey, family. I love you, and I'll see you soon. Blessings to you.
Walk with me, Lord. Walk with me. Anybody remember that one? Come on. Walk with me, Lord. Said I need you to walk with me. Yeah. While I'm on. Hold my hand, Lord. Hold my hand.
Oh, how many want the Lord to hold your hand tonight?
Hold my hand, Lord.
Would you do that for me?
Hold my hand. Yeah. While I'm on this, yeah. Jesus,
your best friend will let you down.
Be my friend, Lord. Oh, Lord, won't you be my friend? Oh, my mind. While I'm on this, oh, Lord, Jesus, journey. Yeah. Ooh, be my friend.